Nung nakaraan, tinalakay natin yung disciplinary authority ng ombudsman over government employees na dito hindi kasama sa disciplinary authority ng ombudsman officers who may be removed only from office by impeachment, yung members ng Congress at saka yung judiciary. Itong tatlo hindi kasama. May isa pa hong hindi kasama dyan sa disciplinary authority ng Office of the Ombudsman. Ito po yung sa kaso ng Ombudsman versus Galicia, JR 16-77-11, decided on October 10, 2008. Dito sa kaso na ito, sinabi na ang Office of the Ombudsman ay wala ring disciplinary authority or administrative jurisdiction over administrative cases, public school teachers. Ang basis dito ay ang RA 4670, itong Magna Carta for Public School Teachers. Kasi dito sa RA 4670, mayroong special procedure para dun sa hearing ng mga public school teachers. Yan ay nakasaado sa Section 9 ng RA 4670, wherein it provides na ang administrative charges against a teacher shall be heard initially by a committee composed of superintendent of school or his duly authorized representative who must have a rank of a division supervisor as chairman. Then as member, ito hong representative ng local teacher organization in his absence, yung provincial teacher organization in the absence of a provincial teacher organization, yung national teacher organization. Another member will be from a division supervisor. Itong dalawa ho na ito ay to be appointed or to be designated by the bureau director who is now called the regional director. So ito hong committee na ito ang mag-hear ho ng under this law. So because of this special provision of the Magna Carta, ang decision ng Supreme Court hindi rin kasama sa itong administrative cases against a public school teacher. Kaya kung may kaso laban sa public school teacher, hindi pwede dun sa Office of the Ombudsman i-file ho yung case against a public school teacher because of this provision of the Magna Carta for Public School Teacher. Ang pwede lang mamili kung ang kalaban ay hindi public school teacher, pwedeng i-file yun sa under Section 21 ng RA 6770 against all public officers and employees elected or appointed dun sa Office of the Ombudsman, pag hindi public school teacher. Or you can file it before the Civil Service Commission pursuant to paragraph 1 of Section 47, Chapter 7, Book 5 of Executive Order number 292, otherwise known as the Administrative Code of 1987. Doon naman pwede rin i-file dito sa disciplining authority ng Department of Education pursuant to the second paragraph of Section 47, Chapter 7, Book 5 of Executive Order number 292. Umako naman tayo sa disciplining authorities ng Department of Education. Tatlo ho ang disciplining authorities ng Department of Education. Una, ang Secretary of Education. Pangalawa po, ang regional directors in the respective regions. Pangatlo, school superintendents in the respective school divisions. Ang jurisdiction po ng Secretary of Education is he has original and exclusive jurisdiction over administrative cases or disciplinary actions against employees at the central office and against presidential appointees, namely the assistant superintendents, superintendents of schools, assistant regional directors, assistant secretary, and the undersecretaries. Cases against them, ang may jurisdiction ay ang Secretary of Education. Sa jurisdiction naman ng regional directors, the regional directors exercise disciplining authority over administrative cases or disciplinary actions against a public school teacher and against employees in their regional offices. Sa superintendents of schools, ang may jurisdiction sa mga kaso ng non-teaching personnel of the Department of Education, ang may jurisdiction dito ay ang superintendents of schools in their respective school divisions. So, it is quite necessary to determine who is a teacher. Dahilan sa ang jurisdiction kung teacher ang respondent, ang may hawak ng disciplining authority over such case, kung teacher yon, regional director. Kung hindi teacher ng teaching personnel, it is the superintendent of schools. So it is necessary to define a teacher. Sa Magna Carta for Public School Teachers, sa Section 2, dinefine ho ang teacher as follows. A teacher shall mean all persons engaged in actual classroom teaching at any levels of instruction on a full-time basis, which includes guidance counselors, school librarians, industrial arts and vocational instructors, and all those exercising supervisory and administrative functions over schools, colleges, and universities operated by the government and its subdivisions, except those who are school dentists, school physicians, and also school nurses. Hindi ho kasama sa term teacher. Sa Section 1 ho, ng Implementing Rules ng RA 4670, nakalista ho doon ang sino-sino ang mga officers of the Department of Education who may be considered as exercising supervisory and administrative functions and those engaged in actual classroom teaching. They are all deemed teachers. So, pagtitingnan po natin ang listahan doon sa implementing rules and regulations na kung sino-sino ang mga teachers, makikita po natin doon na ang school heads, ang supervisors, ang assistant superintendents, at saka superintendents, they are considered teachers under these implementing rules and regulations. Sa last sentence o, ng Section 6, ng revised rules of procedure of the Department of Education in administrative cases. Nakalagay doon na ang Secretary of Education can take cognizance of any case filed at any office of the Department of Education. Ang Secretary of Education has concurrent jurisdiction with the regional directors and also with the superintendents of schools. Kaya halimbawa yung mga kaso na laban sa, halimbawa, sa legal officer ng school division office, may jurisdiction ang school superintendents over case against a legal officer at the school division office. And also, the Secretary of Education has concurrent jurisdiction also. Pursuant to the last sentence of Section 6 of the revised rules of procedure of the Department of Education, in administrative cases. Halimbawa, may administrative case ang isang school nurse. Ang may jurisdiction ho dito ay ang superintendent of school. Cases, administrative actions or disciplinary actions against the school physicians, school dentists, they are considered non-teaching personnel. So, ang may jurisdiction ho dito ay superintendents of schools. Pero sa assistant superintendents, at saka superintendents, being presidential appointees, ang jurisdiction no, ng Secretary of Education dito ay original and exclusive sa kanila.